in your day, right?
The one thing I've noticed recently is that the more that you live, the more that you move into ministry, the more is required of you, so to speak, that you need to be mindful of things that you might not have had to pay as close attention to. For instance, to give you an example, you know, part of my idea behind Evotional was to help me to get to my devotions, so that way I would read them and, you know, enjoy them for what I used to do in my early days as a Christian, which was to read them faithfully, you know, consecutively, consistently, and all except for my utmost for its highest, I used to read at least, oh, I don't know, 3 or 4 devotionals a day, you know, almost up to 8. And when I got away from that, I knew that, you know, I needed to get back to it. So part of being in the ministry when I was writing, and I was writing all these blogs and websites, was that I knew I needed more input so that I could feel and know and experience God for myself personally, as opposed to just sharing what, you know, God was doing in my life, or what God may do in scriptures, and how people can, you know, discover Jesus and get to know him in a more personal, intimate way. But in so doing, likewise, in becoming a ministry, as it expanded and it got bigger, there was the challenge that you still have to have your own personal quiet time. So God took me to a place of dependency, even more so on him, by causing my back to start acting up and slowing me down, so I have to spend more time in, I would say, precision, meaning that I choose certain things to do more wisely with my time than I would have normally, where I could just be frivolous about it. And in that, I like it. I like the idea that God is so personally, intimately involved, that he wants to care for and take care of me and you when we choose to do those things that require more effort or have more outpouring of our soul, so to speak, and he needs to pour into us more of himself and make real in our lives the fact that he's living and he's becoming all of us. And I think that's partly what Christians need to realize, is you aren't called to sit in a church for the rest of your life. You aren't called to go to a church and be a fixture in a temple, sit there and do nothing. But rather, as you grow and as you give out of your life to others, then God moves you and uses you in ways that you never thought possible. And he'll cause you to grow in intimacy and in direction and choices that you'll make, that you'll become like Jesus. And in doing that, he's brought me more to my personal time with him in a more real way and a more dramatic way. In starting your day right, triumph over troubles. Moreover, let us be full of joy now. Let us exult and triumph in our troubles and rejoice in our sufferings, knowing that pressure and affliction and hardship produce patience and unswerving endurance. Romans 5:3. Some days it seems that everything goes wrong, one thing after another. After another, after another, after another. Don't just talk to yourself saying, I just can't take any more of this. Don't talk to your friends saying, I just can't put up with any more of this. Don't struggle with the same test day after day. Instead, talk back literally to the devil as Jesus did. See Luke 4:1-13. If you feel your peace and joy slipping away, then talk about it. Talk to God about it. And if there's an issue that needs to be resolved with him, then resolve it. But if it is an attack from the enemy, then just He's trying to steal joy from you, didn't just say forget it. No, I'm not going to get upset today. And leave it in the Lord's hands and commit it to Him in prayer, and He'll take you there. He will strengthen you. It says that God strengthens the feeble knees and the weak hands, or the weak knees and the feeble hands. Either way. And in so doing, when we commit our way unto God and we trust also in Him, that He brings it to pass. So there's a certain amount of, yes, you can stand up and say, okay, today I'm going to be happy. But at the same time, that's sometimes a self-declaration, kind of like making myself in charge routine, where you're not. You're not in control, and you never were. God is. God is the one who has all of the entire universe in His hands. Like the old song says, He's got the whole world in His hands. Guess what? He's got you in His hands. And He wants to make you into the vessel that He's selected you to be. And when you turn to Him and you ask Him to be that personally involved, then He can cause you to enjoy your life to the degree that no matter what comes, you're happy. Whether it be suffering, whether it be joy, whether it be sorrows, whether it be sadness, whether it be gladness. In all those things, you will find that God with you will cause you to rejoice always in Him. The point is, it's in Him, not without Him. That's the best way to be. That's the only way to be. Always find yourself in Him in any circumstance, and you'll find that it doesn't matter what they are. You will rejoice and be glad in it, because this is the day the Lord has made.